Yo, what's up guys, this is Mosen here and I am bringing you a video about crushing blows and the crushing immunity. Can you get crushing immune? We'll find out. Let's go. So, to determine how many hits of the enemy are going to be crushing blows, there's a formula that calculates this, and it takes into account the mob's weapon skill and the player's level capped defense skill. That means it's 300 for you as a player against a raid boss, because, you know, 5 times 60 is 300, so don't take into consideration any of your defense that you equipped, it's just the pure level defense. So that means for a raid boss, for example, 3 levels higher, that means mob's weapon skill is 315. Minus 300, you calculate that with 2%, you know, times 2%, that is 30, of course, and then minus 15%. And then you end up with 15% of the attacks of the boss are going to be crushing blows. Now, a crushing blow deals 1.5 times the damage that a normal hit would do, and they are pretty dangerous. If you if you catch 1, 2, 3 in a row, you're likely dead, in combination of any other raid mechanics. So this is why you want to avoid this kind of stuff, and here's how we're going to push that off. As an explanation, anything else can crit too. Like when you're wondering why. You know, you might get, when you're leveling, for example, you're tanking a dungeon or something, and, you know, mobs just demolish you, and you went into Cathedral with level 34 like I did. We made it, right? But the mobs were pretty brutal. And that was because they were more than 3 levels above me. The mobs in there are, like, 39, and, you know, I was 34, so you can go figure. Because, you know, if a mob is at least 3 levels higher than the target, you know, you can receive a crushing blow. And here we can really bust the first myth of, you know, gear making you crushing immune. The more defense you stack, at some point you're gonna get crushing immune. I made the other video on the defense skill. You can get crit immune, 440 def. And then after that, you have to push something else to get crushing immune. You can theoretically get crushing immune, but you'll need your abilities to do so. So it's actively mitigating the damage in avoiding crushing blows. Right, but it can be made less likely to occur, and that's when avoidance comes in. And avoidance are stats like parry, dodge, block, you know, that kind of stuff, or being missed, basically. Anything that avoids damage actually hitting you at all. Right, a parry is a parry. You parry the complete attack. That's perfect. That's like the best tanking. It's theoretically the best tanking stats because you completely push other stuff off the table, you know, being normally hit or anything. So that's a really good, those are really, really good stats. So how do we really get crushing immune? Let's jump right into this. As we said, the boss or a creature that is 3 levels above you, right, has a 15% chance to land a crushing blow. That leaves you with 85% not being crushed, basically. If you have 100 attacks, 15 of those are going to be crushing blows, and 85 of those are going to be anything else. We don't know, but something else. So, basically, it's really easy. You need over 85% avoidance somehow. Okay, so for a warrior, this is easier than for other classes, of course. You know, like a feral druid, of course. But Feral Druid makes up for that in a different way. But let's look at the formula here again, okay? So you can have a better understanding. So you have 5% chance to be missed. Or, you know, the boss has 5% miss chance, let's put it that way. Then you can actually add the extra chance to be missed from your defense skill on top of that. If you want to find out more about how that works, what defense skill does, then check the other video on this channel. It's a quick one on defense skill. So you gain extra being missed chance from the defense skill, or, you know, avoid. You add that to your normal miss chance, your base miss chance. Then you add the block chance that you have, right? And then you add the dodge chance and the parry chance. And then that's all your avoidance. That's basically everything that is not a hit that you take, basically. And so I have made an example here. Let's say, you know, it's just random numbers, okay? So this might be totally different. Let's say you have 5% base mischance, then you get another 5.6% from your defense skill. That's when you're crit capped or def capped, 440. Then you have 25% block chance. That's like some, those are some random values from the warrior that I had, what I remembered off the top of my head. Then we got the 15.6% dodge chance and a 10% parry chance with like talents and everything. So put all of that in, anything you find from your talents, and then we end up at 61.2% mitigation. That's passive, basically. And active mitigation comes on top of this. So this is why warriors want to keep their shield block on cooldown, okay? So this is basically the thing, and that makes warriors really good tanks to start out with and in the early game of vanilla, because their block, you know, shield block makes gives them 75% block chance, right? And this results in anything else being pushed off the hit table. Now, if you're confused about the hit table, what that basically means is when you have, like we said, we have 61.2% avoidance if we just stand there and get hit. Now, if we activate, you know, but this already means if you have 61.2%, you know, dodge, parry, everything, if you just stand there and don't do anything, you have 61% that an attack's gonna miss you. If you have less than this, that means more attacks are on the table that will hit you and have a normal chance. Now, in this case, with the 61.2%, the 15% crushing blows are still on the table. And the table is always 100%. And this is why you want to push your mitigation above 85%, so that then anything you're above 85%, slowly pushes the crushing blows off the table and off the table and off the table. If you are at 100% avoidance, then the crushing blows are off the table. Out of 100 hits being made against you, there's zero crushing blows happening. It's the same with the crit cap. Like if you're, you know, if you are crit immune, then the crits are not on the table anymore. Or let's say the, you know, the crit, yeah, basically the crits are not on the table anymore. And that's what you want to achieve, making block chance, you know, for warrior not as valuable, because their block, their shield block already increases it by 75%. That means you're way above 100% avoidance if you calculate everything on top. And that is basically why warriors are very, very good. Now, for protection paladins, right, you have the holy shield, which is actually not that bad, to be quite honest. If you take the example into consideration that we just discussed with the 61.2% that you have baseline, let's say that's a paladin, a prop paladin, and you can actually keep the holy shield up the whole duration, right? So you don't have it as, you know, you don't have so much, but you can almost have it up the whole time as well. You have charges, of course, right? So, and since a whole, you know, a prot paladin is usually an AoE or an add tank, but just, I mean, just in case, right? Let's take this as an example. And you can keep the holy shield up quite, you know, almost 100% of the time. And that allows you to have another 30% chance to block. Now, that means in this case it would have 91.2% mitigation, which would leave you at, you know, something, you know, like 8 something percent to get crushed. Feral druids of course have a much harder time because the whole blocking is gone. That doesn't make them bad tanks though at all. You know, feral tanks are pretty good because they have a lot more dodge through their agility, and they have a much larger health pool and armor pool to negate those crushing blows. Basically, have the you know, they soak more, let's put it that way. They take that crushing blow in, but they reduce it and you know, take in more, basically. And there you go. Now, as a final note, I'll provide the hit tables here again. I know how confusing this can sound if you have never heard of these hit tables. I was like, what table, what are you talking about? And it's really easy to understand if you see a picture, so I'm putting that in here. And basically what you can say is you know, the anything gets pushed off the table, and that is because crushing blows, for example, can not be blocked, right? So if you have more block chance at the end of the day, the crushing blows are pushed off the table. You know, the probability of getting a crushing blow is zero, and you know, you cannot dodge critical hits. So the dodge and the block stays on the table along with miss, being missed and parry, right? That's how I kind of remember it. I don't know if that's 100% correct, correctly said in a theory crafting sense, but that's how I remember it, and that kind of makes sense to me. And right, so there you go. Just imagine it. If you're very unsure, just imagine every attack the game rolls dice, and whatever is the outcome is, you know, you can influence that. At some point, the probability of them rolling a crushing blow is not on the table anymore, right? You only have the other outcomes left on the table. And there you go, this is the crushing immunity, if you will, I hope you enjoyed this, and you know, it helped you a little bit, because it was certainly a little bit confusing for me at the start. Right, and that's basically it. If you enjoyed the video, then leave something, a comment or a like or a sub, and would love to see you on Twitch when I stream. That being said, enjoy your day and have a good time. Bye-bye.